All right, here we are for round number one. Opponents on the play and mulligans, and I'm pretty sure that I have to also mulligan this hand here. I could cast Dismember, Displacer if I draw a land, but I can't cast anything else, and not an exciting hand. I'd rather have see if I can do better, and this looks way better. So we'll keep this. Scrying a Plains. I'm going to scry that to the bottom. I have Ancient Stirrings to find lands. I would rather draw an Eldrazi Temple. I want to give myself the highest chance of drawing a temple as I can, so I can play the Thought Knot on two. Might get Thoughtseized here though. Positioned. Okay, well, I'm losing probably Noble Hierarch, I would assume. Could be Ancient Stirrings if our opponent has a removal spell for a Noble. No, taking the Hierarch, probably the right play. Well, that's not what I wanted to draw. Strings. Well, Eldrazi Temple is calling to me, so. Yep, take the temple. Thoughtseize. Okay, bye bye, Thoughtseizer. Smasher. It's a nice one. Alright, Stirrings again. Taking, I think, just another temple. Yep. I'm gonna take another temple here. That way, I can actually play Reality Smasher on turn three. Really gonna be, which is really good against Liliana. There's a Liliana here, which doesn't look like there was. I think Liliana would have been cast if it was in the mix. So we'll just play the Smasher and smash on in. Hopefully I don't get Liliana'd. So if our opponent had Liliana and didn't cast it, that was certainly a great play. See what's going on here. End step. Bloodstained Mire for, I don't know, Blood Crypt maybe? Stomping Ground? Who knows? Fortunately, one of my Drowners is on the bottom of my deck. Drowner would be quite good here. But, yep, hopefully, I don't know if playing the Smasher was correct, but I guess Overgrown Tomb's a good one. I could have just Stirringed and maybe tried to find another Thought Knot Seer, like a Matter Reshaper or something. Alright, Thought Seize, probably take the other Stirrings. Yep. No play, so. Well, that's nice. Alright, so Jund, the Jund life. What do I side against Jund? I don't want Spellskite. Non-creature spell, so. Denials, I don't know, I don't think Denials that good against a removal deck. I could see Explosives being good. I want all my removal. I don't know how good these birds and things are. I could see explosives being a strong one. Or stubborn denial. Denial is pretty good. But a lot of Jun's creatures are 2, and explosives on 2 doesn't kill any of our stuff, so I think I'd rather go 2 explosives. Could even see cutting the birds for a 3rd explosives. Nah, we'll just go 2. Could also see like a stubborn denial being okay, but could be awkward too. I'm gonna keep this hand, but we don't have a green source, so it's a little awkward. Maybe we'll draw one on turn 1. Did not. Alright, so we're on that matter reshaper life. Is this Bobby? Excuse. Excuse is okay. Alright. Would love to draw land. Love it. How about a forest? Just basic forest. Well, there's a forest. How come he gets a basic forest and I don't? Discard a card. Alright, Noble Hierarch. Alright, how about into play? Yeah, we'll put that on the battlefield. Sign me up. I don't think I want a path of scavenging ooze. So we'll take it. And then I'll fetch for a Temple Garden. That worked out well. Ooh, and I drew another land, so start with Thought on Seer. Looking at a hand to terminate Dismember. Well, looks like Terminate's the one that's going. So Dismember, Blood Crypt, Bloodstained Mire. I always like to write down what they have so that you never get surprised by anything. And then I'll just play Noble Hierarch. So imagine Thought Not Seer is going to get dismembered. I'm gonna have to path this scavenging ooze eventually, probably next turn. It's gonna get a little out of control, so I'm guessing this is the old dismember. I see the life total moving, so probably a dismember. Yep. I thought not. You did not do your job of ridding the hand of removal spells. Scavenging ooze. Yeah, eating a couple of creatures and then smashing me for 4. Probably playing that Blood Crypt, I would assume, maybe. Yep. Dismember. Okay, that's a good one. I can dismember this. I can dismember something. Probably better to dismember this than path it. Alright, start with stirrings. See what we yield up from this. Looks like Smasher. I like Smasher. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I could attack for 6. Yeah, let's take the Smasher. But I think that I would rather preserve my life total here. So if I smash for 6, I could be taking 5. I could be taking 8 on the swing back. Seems a little too dangerous, especially because that would shut off Dismember. So just cast the Reshaper. And pass the turn. I could attack with Noble Hierarch, but I would like to have access to Path and Dismember. Probably should have. Maybe should I just. I should have just dismembered this right off the bat. So there's that Bloodstained Mire, so I no longer know any of the cards in our opponent's hand. Just a Raging Ravine activation. It's kind of what I'm hoping for. It is. Alright. Dismember the Ravine. Path the Scoozy. Now I have Smasher to play next turn as well. It's pretty good. That's what I will do. Now, is there a reason to not just play this? I don't think so. I think it's just no reason to not play it. Could be some world where I want it in play. Cletus. That's not good. Yeah, that's really bad. It's not the worst possible. Well, sending in the Smasher. There's no value in holding back Reality Smasher to block because it can't block Cletus anyway. Opponent can just sacrifice a zombie to grow Cletus, so just basically no value at all in that exchange. Assuming our opponent has some sort of terminate, yeah. Yep. It's not good. Just taking it here. I can't do anything else. Probably gonna sack a zombie to pump the Cletus. So I really need to draw a path to exile. Displacer, ooh, that's good. That is good too. Man, I only have one colorless source though. Be. Do I blink the zombie token or the Cletus? Probably the zombie token. Now I have to chump block with Noble Hierarch. Try to win that way. Splicer was a nice draw. Hope. That's a good one. In a field of both players drawing some really good ones, that is a good one. I think I'm still in kind of bad shape, but could be worse. If our opponent just has nothing, I think I'm fine. But somehow I doubt that. He's just sitting there on two cards in hand, not playing any lands. I mean, could be holding back lands for Reality Smasher. Okay, there's a land, so maybe. Maybe he's on nothing. I do have to blink Huntmaster in the upkeep. I'm at two life. Can't let that flip. Two, three, four, five, six, so cancel. Alright, so I want to do like, I'm gonna have to probably blink this like every single turn. Actually, let's let's just do that. In case I draw a spell, which I don't. I'll draw Z. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I can blink a few things this turn if I need to. Unfortunately, I have to blink that. Since I didn't cast any spells. Ugh. If our opponent doesn't draw like a removal spell or something pretty soon, though, I can maybe win this game. Like, I think if our opponent bricks off here, I can win. Beating this Huntmaster might be problematic. I need to draw, like, a path. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Path to exile would be nice. Or I need to stabilize so that I can start to pull ahead. Okay, so end step. I think I just... Exile this Drowner of Hope. Now I have to exile the Huntmaster. It's not where I want to be. Oh, Path to Exile, that is very nice. One, two, three, four, five, six. Yeah, I think that's going to be enough to stabilize if our opponent bricks one more time. Alright, let's path the Huntmaster. If our opponent bricks again, I think I can start to clear off some of the stuff. No! Oh, lightning bolt targeting me! Alright. Oof, yeah, we were getting it done. Alright, Cletus, you say. Huntmasters and Cletus. Yeah, I wonder if explosives is actually any good. Maybe I'll try Stubborn Denial. Yeah, it doesn't hurt to try it. I'll try two Stubborn Denials instead of the explosives. I mean, explosives on zero would have been pretty good there. But that was kind of an oddball situation. Ugh. I'll keep. I'm not happy about it though. I'm not sure if naming Eldrazi is right. Probably not. Well, yeah, probably not. Okay, no plays so far. Another Stubborn Denial. Ugh. Not what I wanted to draw, both my Stubborn Denials. If I can draw a temple though, I can play Thought Knot with Stubborn Denial up, which would be nice. Watery Grave. What? That is something. Nope. Instead, I just do not draw a land. Oh, gross. Watery Grave. Would not have expected to see Watery Grave. It's probably a Huntmaster or something of that kind. Let's name human for this one. And cast Noble Hierarch off it. Let's see what we can get here. Okay, wow, not that great of a hand. I might have a chance. Black Cleave, Forest, Swamp, Lightning Bolts. Take the Terminate. Yep, time to get Raged on. Maybe I should have even blocked. I don't know. I do have this Drowner in hand, though. Displacer. Alright, I'm glad I named Eldrazi on one of these. Counter the lightning bolts. Alright, don't have drawn a removal spell for Thought Nonseer, or else this is all gonna crumble. Okay. That's a little bit risky there, because I wouldn't have Ferocious if Thought Not dies, so. Okay, Verdant Catacombs. So that means that's another dead draw that was in the mix. Oh, just let me keep this Displacer alive one more time. No attacks. Draw a land. Ugh, I just want to draw a land so bad. I think I'm gonna attack with a Thought Knot. It's probably an activation of Ravine. Yep. Trading, which I'm okay with. And Thought Knot number two. Hopefully something was drawn off that which I can strip. Nope. Just a bunch of four lands. Alright, so Forest, Swamp, Ravine, Verdant. Alright. Sadly, I don't feel that great about this game despite that our opponent having nothing. Things could easily fall apart with some good draws. There's a Ravine. Here's one of the draws, Huntmaster. Okay, it's not the worst. It's not the end of the world as we know it. Alright, I drew a land. Send in the Thought Knot. No blocks. And then I have to play another one. Not what I want to do, especially since I know it's going to brick, but just need to advance my board. Once I can get the Drowner of Hope in play, if I can assemble Drowner plus Displacer, that's pretty good. Also, having the second Thought Knot insulates me for Stubborn Denial, which is nice. Probably a Ravine activation. Yep. All right. just gonna take the 4. I don't want to trade Thought Not for it this time. The swamp. And I'm just gonna let Huntmaster flip. Well, that Thought Knot's not gonna be sending, not gonna be crashing in. True land, good one. Let's attack with the other Thought Knot. I think I'm okay just trading and getting Huntmaster off the board. Master is just such a problem. So I have the option of casting Drowner of Hope, or leaving up Stubborn Denial plus Displacer. I think I'd rather leave up Stubborn Denial plus Displacer. Because if I draw one more land, then I can cast Drowner with Stubborn Denial mana available. That seems it seems way better to play it conservatively in that regard. This is another Huntmaster. I'll be very sad. Oh my god, are you kidding me? How many Huntmasters are there? And Kalidus too? Jeez. It's unreal. Ugh, gross. Start the process of getting these wolves out of here. Yeah, I think I'm gonna blow. Well, this is interesting. I'm gonna do it again. It might be stupid to not leave up Stubborn Denial, but it's also stupid to just never do something here. So if I get hit by a removal spell, then so be it. Yeah, it looks like that's gonna happen. God, Huntmaster is so annoying. Opponent just has 35 Huntmasters. Alright, fine. Displacer's dead. Breeding pool. I should probably use this cavern just for the sake of safety. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe that was stupid to play it like that. Here I'm just going to play this tapped just because I don't want to take 2 damage and give away the fact that I have the Stubborn Denial. Might be stupid, but I think our opponent is hopefully running out of not just drawing a removal spell every single turn of the game. A triple Huntmaster, that is a beating. Alright, should I... Oh no, what is this? Oh, and activating it again. Okay. Yeah, I'll tap it down. I think I made the right play with that, I think I made the right play when it comes to, choosing to use the displacer at the end of turn, but I don't know. I guess it's possible that I should have just have never exposed it. I I don't know, it's just if I never draw, like I'm starting to fall behind if I don't actually advance my board at all, so well, losing the Scion, so tap that stupid thing down. Path to Exile, that's a good one. Because I drew Path, I wonder if I can. So if he double activates that's 6, 7, 8. So I could Path this. And then I would just take 6. Yeah, I could do that. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Eight, yeah. That seems like the thing to do. I'm at 7, so yeah, it's not lethal. I could get like double bolted out or something, but Inquisition of Kozluck. No! Alright, Stubborn Denial that. That was bad. That was a bad one. I think I lose now because I had to cast that Stubborn Denial. Because now, double activating Raging Ravine, I have to play this path, so Huntmaster's gonna flip back again. And then, if I don't draw a spell, it's gonna flip again. So, I need to draw like Reality Smasher or Displacer or something. Although if he leaves the wolf, okay, he didn't leave the wolf back. All right, so I have to path the Raging Ravine. Go to 1. Oh, that Inquisition making me cast a second spell to flip this back. All right, I'm at 1. Our opponent's up to 5. Need to draw something here. Path to Exile. All right. Well, when you run hot, you run hot. Path the Wolf Token and get in for 5, or get in for 9. I'd say we had about maybe 12 outs in our deck, 15 outs in our deck. Alright, send with both in case some sort of removal spell here should still be lethal. Alright, wow, we ended up winning the match. I might have messed up with that displacer thing, but we got the job done anyway, barely. That was a hell of a match, man. Huntmaster of the Fells. This card right here. Huntmasters and Kalidus and oof. That was an ugly Jund deck for us to have to face. But we won, so up 1-0. Hopefully you stay tuned for the rest of the matches.